Welcome to this Unreal 5 tutorial. In this video, I'll be taking you through the basic steps of getting MassTraffic AI working in your project. This is a bare minimum step-by-step guide, but come back later for a more advanced guide. So let's get started. First, let's create a new blank project and give it a name. Once the project has loaded, we close the editor again. Now you open your project folder and create a folder called plugins. Then you either extract the plugins from the CitySample plugins folder or download them from the link in the description. Then place them in our newly created plugins folder in our project. Now open your project again and go to the plugins menu. Search for traffic and activate the traffic plugin. Next, restart the editor. Now let's open the Epic Marketplace and find the CitySampleVehicles. Then add them to your project. Find and open the BP Vehicle Blueprint. Click Enable Missing on the two pop-ups. And restart the editor. Once back in the editor, we want to create our own vehicle blueprint. So let's create a new blueprint class and pick Actor as our parent class. Name it Low Res Car and open it. In here we want to add a static mesh and name it Body. Let's add another static mesh for a wheel and duplicate it 3 times. The wheel order must be front left, front right, rear left, rear right. This is the order the plugin expects. Add another static mesh for the windows. Now open the content browser and find a vehicle from the CitySampleVehicles. I'm gonna go with vehicle 03. Then drag the appropriate meshes into the mesh component. If we want our wheels to be spinning and turning, we have to add a MassTraffic vehicle component. Now go to the construction script and drag in the MassTraffic vehicle component. From it, drag and place a Set Wheels component node. Connect it to the construction script and from the wheel components, drag and place a MakeArray node. Add three more pins and drag all four wheel components into the construction script. Remember to connect them in the right order. Front left, front right, rear left, rear right. Now let's drag in the body component and drag and place a set custom primitive data float from it. This is an important step. The traffic plugin uses this custom primitive data float for storing vehicle color and real-time vehicle light toggles. And without setting this data, your project will crash. Change the data index to 1. Now we place a Git packed traffic vehicle instant custom data. From the out packed custom data, we drag and place a break mass traffic packed vehicle instant custom data and connect the output to the value input and the body to the primitive component. In the advanced guide, I will be showing you how to toggle the vehicle lights and change per instant vehicle color. So remember to subscribe so you get notified when the guide is ready. Next, we click Class Settings and add the interface Mass Actor Poolable Interface. Now open the interface and double click Can be pooled and make sure the return value is true. Go back to the interface and double click Prepare for game and prepare for pooling. Drag and place a set actor enable collision. Duplicate and connect one more. And make sure collision is false for pooling and true for game. Now we're done with our car blueprint, so let's compile and save. Next, we want to make a new data asset and pick Mass Entity Config Asset as our parent class. Let's call it Car Agent. Open it and let's add three traits. First trait is a LOD collector. Next trait is a traffic vehicle simulation. And last trait is a traffic vehicle visualization. Now expand visualization and under low res template actor, we pick our low res car. We will be adding the static mesh instance and high res actor in the advanced guide, but for now, just keep them at none. Expand the params and the LOD representation. For now, pick the low res spawned actor as high, medium, and low. Next, we expand traffic vehicle simulation and then params. In half length, we type in 284. In half width, we type in 109. In front axle, we type in 152. And lastly, rear axle, -145. Save and exit. Now let's go to the project settings, zone graph, and add a new lane profile. Expand it, give it a name, and add two lanes. Give the width a value of 400 on both lanes. Change the direction of the second lane to backward. Expand tags and give the first tag a name of car lane. Then close the project settings. Now open the Place Actors panel. Search for zone and drag in a zone shape. Make sure it has our defined lane profile and tags. Duplicate the zone shape a couple of times and let's build a square. Leave the corners for now though. Line up the small triangles in the middle so they turn white. Go to the Build menu and select Build Zone Graph. Now let's build a corner. Duplicate a shape and drag it to the corner. In the Details panel, select Shape Type and change it to a polygon. Then under Selected Point, select Type and change it to Lane Profile. Do the same for the other point. Now rotate the points so they match the lanes. Then copy this zone shape to the other corners and make it line up to the lanes. Now let's build the zone graph again. Now let's save the map so we don't lose anything if the editor crashes. Now let's open the Place Actors panel again and type in mass. Find the mass spawner and drag it into the scene. In the details panel under mass spawn, type in a number like 5. Then add a new entity type and let's select the car agent we made earlier. Next, add a new spawn data generator. And then select mass traffic vehicle spawn data generator. Now we're almost ready to test it out. We just have to add a console command so the editor doesn't crash when we hit play. In the console, type in traffic and find traffic parallelization and add a 0 and enter. This turns off traffic multithreading and keeps the editor from crashing. Now let's test it out. Hit play. And there you are, vehicles driving in our project. But the wheels are not turning and we're using low simulation mode. Let's fix that in a moment, but first let's enjoy the cars driving around. We can spawn more cars with the mass spawner selected and clicking debug spawn. If you want to see the shown shapes, go to show in the top of the screen and click navigation. Stop the simulation and let's fix wheels not spinning. Let's open the car agent data asset. Then under traffic vehicle simulation params, find physics vehicle template actor and select the BP vehicle that you chose at the start of the guide. This will let the vehicles run with full physics simulation. Save and exit and let's try and play again. But as you can see now, our corners are too tight and we need to make them bigger. Select each corner and change the polygon routing type to Bezier. When we have fixed the corners, let's rebuild the zone graph and hit play. And there you go. This concludes the step-by-step guide. This was just a basic guide, but in the next advanced guide, I'll be going through high-res actors, instant static meshes, lighting system, intersection, and more zone graph. Should be a lot of fun, so remember to subscribe so you get notification when the new video is out. Goodbye for now, and thank you for watching.